At times we apply this one-size-fits-all mentality to everything. And sometimes it might be good with a t-shirt. But when we're thinking about decision-making or things that will affect our lives, we have to realize that what might be good for one family or good for someone else, it might even be a brother or sister, might not be good for you. And we have to remain focused on our part. So, let's go. Hello, my name is Paula Simon, a believer who 25 plus years ago made a decision that changed my life, strengthened my faith, which led to a closer walk with God. On this platform, I encourage women to embrace changes one step at a time and to be more proactive in their lives. So if you're new to this channel, welcome, welcome, welcome. And if you're a returning subscriber or viewer, welcome also. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification button so YouTube will notify you when a new video is up. So as I said in the introduction, is that we at times, regardless of our walk, regardless of our faith, we have to be, circumspect, or we have to take care of what we bring into our mind and into our spirit. Case in point, myself. Yesterday, in fact, whole week, the whole of last week, I was working on my video, jotting down the outline, what I would like to talk about. But then yesterday, I was listening to someone that I really do like. I like her message. She has a great personality. And she said is that she would hear, they said, be consistent in putting up your videos and that will help you to build audience. So she's saying that she don't buy into this being consistent with video. She don't think it works. It only works if you have a strategy in order to build your audience, which in turn will be able to for you to market products or offer training or courses, whatever the case may be. So as she said that this have a strategy, like started to hit me. And I started thinking, Paul, you don't have a strategy. You start this video because you honestly believe this is what God tells you to do. And you know that whatever you are experiencing now or had experienced in the past or will experience in the future, you share it, it will be a help to someone out there. You might never see the person, know the person, even hear back from that person, but you know whatever God placed in your life, whatever experience he gave you, and he helping you to relate it. In that way, it will touch a soul. It will touch someone. It will be of help. That was my strategy. So when she started talking about this person, that when I first looking at her, she didn't have much viewers, but her channel is growing. She get audience. Now she's having conference and retreats and all of these great stuff. I'm thinking that, Paula, did you miss something? So, but I don't have a strategy. But what I could tell you, that little slow down my preparation for the video. I must admit it, although I wouldn't want to. With all I know, with all my feelings, with all my experiences, that remark or those set of words that she used, it created a little in my spirit. So I slowed down on my preparation for the video because, Paula, perhaps you're approaching it the wrong way. I went to sleep, woke up this morning. Just as I took my feet off of the bed and put it on the floor, the Holy Spirit said, the moment. And when I hear this the moment in my spirit, I get a recollection of an experience. I saw right away T.D. Jakes walking on the stage at the Superdome in New Orleans in August 2001. And he said, think outside the box. I think I had mentioned it before. And if not, I'll say it now, is that I cannot remember anything about that seminar. It was a conference of women that were loose. Later on, I did research with over 70,000 women was there and all of that. There's nothing about that conference I could remember. I could remember the trip to New Orleans. I remember the food that I ate. walking around and looking at stuff and saying New Orleans. I could remember all of that, but I cannot remember anything else about that seminar other than seeing him. He's in my mind eyes, walking on stage in a white t-shirt, came from the right side of the stage in a white t-shirt. And as he was walking, he was not even at the podium. As he came on the stage, he was saying, you have to think outside the box. And that was my message. It was like a punch in my stomach. Because guys, let me give you a little backstory. I will try to make it as short as possible, because it could be long. You see, that was in August 2001. In March 2001, while standing, it had to be sometime after 5, standing at the bus station in Queens, New York, just exit the E train at the very last stop, at the Jamaica stop, standing there waiting for the number 83 bus, I made a decision. I said, if next year, time like now, I was standing at that bus station, I would have been working for myself. Because the previous year was November 2000. I joined the Bank of New York and I was working there. But the commute with the bus and the train was horrible, because rush hour, the buses are overcrowded. The train overcrowded, there's always a delay, person standing up with a handbag, the half a sock, everything in your face, there's nothing you could do or say about it. Some of them even have the stuff in your face and they're looking at you like daring you to say something. And guys, I can't fight. So what I'll do is sit there. Sometimes you stand for hours because there's delay. Then you go into the office again, that will have its own little politics and dealing with. So I'm doing this commute, 4 buses, 4 trains, 2 buses, 2 trains every day. And then the hours in the off. So I was standing there that afternoon, waiting for the 83 bus, which usually was always late. And the line keep getting longer and longer. So based on where you get in, you are in that line, that will determine whether or not you have a seat or a bag in your face. I made a decision that by the next year, I would not be part of that. I didn't know how it was happening. And really and truly, guys, if you look at the whole situation, I was not supposed to be making having the kind of thought about wanting to quit a job and work for myself. But that was the decision I made. So at the time, my 2 girlfriends that went out in New Orleans with me, I mentioned it to them. Sometime between the time I made the decision and when I went out to New Orleans, I mentioned it to them. I can't remember anyone saying anything to me. But you see, the thing about it, God knows everything. And God knows we all would have been in that hotel room in New Orleans. Even before we started planning to go, God knows what would have happened. And he knew I needed something in order to stand firm. Because so said so, when we went back into the hotel room, we were talking. And rightfully, in the scheme of things, they voiced their concern. Because one was an RN. And anyone out in New York know those RNs have the opportunity for earn $1. The rate was high and the hours the work was available. The other one, she had just gotten her master's. She's having a good pay. She was married. Her husband had a secure job. Let's put it this way. Between the two of them, they could have split my expenses per month and paid, and it won't even affect their pocket any bit. Out of the 3 of us, those 2 women were far financially secure than I am, or I was at that time. So as a friend, that would be their concern. So when we get back into the hotel room and we're talking about it, one of the things I can't remember which one of them raised it. Well, Paulie, you know, you're planning to leave. Well, how are you going to make out? Which is not there being negative. It is a valid question and a valid concern. But then, because I had that revelation already in the day, because I knew in my spirit that message that T.D. Jakes, those words that T.D. Jakes stated, I don't care who else was in the dorm at that time, I know it was for me. So with that, I tell them, I say, okay, TD Jakes just said we have to think outside the box. And I said, I've been going to work all the time and helping God to take care of me. It's time that he take on the job full time. And so said, so the next year, I resigned from the bank. That was a moment. So let me put it together with what I heard yesterday, what I taught this morning, and what I'm telling you now. My impression was, or my feeling for a brief, not moment, a brief hours was, oh, Paul, you don't have a strategy in order to grow your YouTube channel. But I have a message and I have a word. And just, I'm certain TD Jakes had a strategy for his conference. And I'm certain they had several, who know, thousands of people who went to that conference who got messages in different areas. And that, you have to think outside the box, I might have been the only person who it hit home for. But you know what? I was there in that moment. And that what it is that my videos might not have all this thing in all the strategies in order to grow my channel in which to do that. I don't know. But what I know for certain, beyond a shadow of a doubt, is that I have a message. I have something, I could share experiences, and I have words and encouragement that could benefit someone. I don't know if the moment had passed, if the moment will be this video, or it will be the video in the future. But what I know is I would experience a moment, or someone would experience a moment from listening to my video. And as I said in the introduction, this one-size-fits-all approach, that is what I was applying. Because what she said, it is not wrong. And in the sense of business, this is how you're supposed to do planning, or you have a thing, or you have a goal. Perhaps this is how God tell her to operate. But this is not how he tell me. Or let me rephrase it. He might have said it, and I didn't get it. And I get it, that's it. But as I stand here, I would say, this is not what he told me. We have to be careful when we're listening, and especially in this day of social media. And especially this day that someone could raise the camera and show you your beautiful shoes and a bag and an outfit, and you're looking at what you have and it is not enough. Or someone come and tell you, okay, they graduated and they get this, or they achieve that, or the triple the income. And the biggest thing, if you look at YouTube, is all who reach six-figure salary, or all who's millionaires and all of these things. And if we are not careful, and one of the problems which I'm guilty of was, although I have so much a frame of reference, although I know in my heart of heart that God told me what to do, I still, because of what I listen, allow it to prick my spirit. But you know what? Again, I always tell you guys, God knows your heart. He knows how much you might be earnestly want to follow his will. And when you go off course, which you know would happen, he just pull you back in. So what he did, the minute my feet hit the ground this morning, he said, moment, and then he bring back. In my mind eye, sitting at the edge of the bed, I saw TD Jakes in that, with a white shirt or a white t-shirt, walk onto the stage. And he said, you have to think outside the box. So guys, this is what I would like to share with you today. Have extra self-care about your goals and your dream. Treat it like a premature baby. Sometimes you just have to keep it covered and not share, or keep certain persons or situations, or who knows, even videos, away from your baby. Because when God gives you something to do, remember that regardless of how much we serve him and how much we believe in him and we are his children, we are still living in the world. So it's not to say whatever grace and strength we had yesterday, we're able to apply today. It's a 24/7 job we have. Along with God, we will be able to do it. It's to guard our thoughts, guard our emotion, guard our feelings, and in the process, we will take care of our goals and dreams. I hope this video has been a help to you. And if for any reason you start putting on the size and telling yourself that this size is going to fit me, you got to remember that you are uniquely made. God has a plan for each one of us. And providing you're still here breathing, that means He needs you to carry out His mission on earth. And if you're a willing soldier, He will give you the strength and the grace in order to do it. And when you go off track, He will just bring you back. Take it from me, guys. You trust Him, He don't allow you to go too long wayward. He brings you right back in. And that's what He did for me this morning. In fact, you guys see in this video, Monday, this is what He did for me yesterday morning. So guys, have a great week. And don't forget to like, subscribe, turn on the notification button. And anything, please share with me in the comment section. Let me know how you were able to get back on track. How God talks to you. Take care. And see you next week. Bye.